Good morning, students. Myself, Bharat Kumar Alain, lecturer, Department of Zoology, Kalpataru First Year Science College, Tiptur. Today, I am going to discuss topic on comparative anatomy for first PSCC visit second semester students. Paper 2, Comparative Anatomy and Developmental Biology of Vertebrates, prescribed by the Tumkur University. Today, we will discuss about comparative account of pelvic girdle of amphibian, bird, mammal under the unit comparative anatomy. And today what we are going to discuss, the syllabus is same for both theory as well as practicals. Okay, coming to the pelvic girdle, it is an appendicular skeleton. Already you know that appendicular skeleton is one which is having the skeletal elements on the transfer axis of the body. Pelvic girdle is located in the hind region of trunk or pelvic region or caudal region. It provides support to the hind limb bones like femur, tibia and fibula. It also provides surface area for the attachment of muscles that are found on that particular region. Pelvic girdle is made up of three bone elements, namely ilium, ischium and pubis. Coming to the pelvic girdle of amphibian or frog. In this diagram, you can see all the three bone elements which are involved in the formation of pelvic girdle, and you can also see the location of all these three bones, namely ilium, ischium and pubis. In frog, pelvic girdle is located in the posterior part of the trunk region. Pelvic girdle is more or less V-shaped bone, which is made up of two similar halves. Each half of the pelvic girdle is also called as osoinnominatus. Each osoinnominatus, which in turn made up of three bone elements, namely ilium, ischium and pubis. In this slide, you are going to see only left half of the pelvic girdle. Okay, coming to the component of the pelvic girdle, ilium forms the first component of the pelvic girdle. Ilium is an elongated bone. You can see in the diagram, ilium is an elongated bone which extends anteriorly. And at the anterior end of the ilium bone, you can see the presence of articular facet, which articulates with the transverse process of the ninth vertebra of vertebral column. And on the dorsal surface of the ilium bone, you can see the presence of iliac crest. Ilium is followed by ischium, once again which forms the bone component of the pelvic girdle. Ischium extend or present towards the posterior end, and it is a larger and oval in shape, which is followed by pubis. Pubis is highly reduced and it is made up of calcified cartilage. All these three bone components meet to form a disc structure posteriorly on the outer surface, which is known as acetabulum. You can see in the diagram the presence of acetabulum on the outer surface, which is formed by the union of all these three bone components, where the head of your femur bone fit and articulates. Coming to the next one, pelvic girdle of bird or pigeon. In this diagram, I will show the location of all bone elements, that is ilium followed by ischium followed by pubis followed by ilioischiatic foramen, which separates the ilium bone from ischium bone, followed by acetabulum where the head of femur bone fit and articulates, followed by obturator foramen which separates the ischium bone from pubic bone. In birds, pelvic girdle is dorsoventrally flattened irregular bone which consists of two equal halves. Each half of the pelvic girdle we call it as osoinnominatum, which in turn made up of three bone elements, namely ilium, ischium and pubis. In case of birds, pelvic girdle is located on either side of the synsacrum. Synsacrum is a compound bone which is formed by the fusion of 6 lumbar, 2 sacral and 7 caudal vertebrae. At the junction of all these three bone elements, we can see the presence of a cup-like depression known as acetabulum, where the head of humeral bone fits and articulates. Okay, coming to the ilium. In the previous diagram, I have already shown the location of all the bone elements. Ilium is a elongated and expanded bone, which expands on both sides, that is anterior as well as posterior side. On the posterior side, it extends up to the acetabulum. The inner margin of the ilium bone is fused with the syncrasacrum, which is a compound bone, whereas the posterior part of the ilium is fused with the ischium bone. On the outer surface, just above the acetabulum, you can see the presence of antitrochanter, which articulates with the greater trochanter of the femur bone. Ilium is followed by ischium. Once again, ischium is also a dorsoventrally flattened bone, which projecting backwards behind the acetabulum and parallel to the posterior part of the ilium bone, which is followed by pubis. Pubis is a long, slender bone, once again, which is directed backwards. Pubic and ischium is separated by a slit-like opening known as obturator foramen. Pubic in front and outside the acetabulum, it gives a prepubic process. Coming to the pelvic girdle of mammal or rabbit. In case of rabbit, pelvic girdle is more or less H-shaped bone, which is made up of two similar halves. Each of the pelvic girdle is also called as osoinnominatum. In rabbit, both the halves of pelvic girdle is united midventrally by pubic symphysis. You can see in the diagram, both the halves of the pelvic girdle is united midventrally by pubic symphysis. Each osoinnominatum, which in turn made up of three bone elements, namely ilium, ischium and pubis. You can see in the diagram, on the outer middle side of the innominate bone, there is a presence of cup-like structure known as acetabulum, where the head of femur bone fit and articulates. In case of mammal, both ilium and ischium participate in the formation of acetabulum, but pubic does not take participation in the formation of acetabulum because a small cotyledon bone prevents it reaching from the acetabulum. Coming to the ilium, ilium is a large blade-like bone, you can see in the diagram, and it is fused with the sacrum and it is provided with articular surface for sacrum. Ilium is followed by ischium. Ischium forms the posterior dorsal part of the innominate bone. Both the sides of the ischium bone meet and fuse to form ischiatic symphysis. Ischium is followed by pubis, which is a small slender bone which forms the ventromedial portion of the innominate bone. Pubis is separated from ischium by a large opening known as obturator foramen. Thank you very much.